Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is Unit 4, Geometry. In this chapter we are going to start about construction of quadrilateral. So what is quadrilateral here? The word quad suggests, the word quad means 4. So what is quadrilateral here? Quadrilateral means it is a plane figure which has how many sides? 4 sides. A quadrilateral is a plane figure which has 4 sides. Now I am drawing one quadrilateral here. Naming is A, B, C and D. So the line segments are the line segment in this quadrilateral is AB, BC, CD and DA. So I am writing the line segment as AB, BC, CD and DA. If I join this line, this and this, if I join D and B and A and C, these are the diagonals of the quadrilateral. So diagonals of quadrilaterals are, what are they? DB and AC. DB and AC. Line segment joining the two vertices are known as the diagonal of the quadrilateral. So what are the diagonal of the quadrilateral here? It is AC and DB. Now I will write down angles of quadrilateral. Angles of quadrilateral. So what will be the angle? It will be DAB, again ABC, from here BCA and CDA. So I am writing the first one, what it will be? DDAB, this is angle DAB. The second one will be ABC, angle A, B, C. From it will, here it will be B, C, D. Angle B, C, D. Again from here it will be D, C, A. Angle D, C, A. So here we have got four angles. That is, the first one is DAB. Second is ABC, ABC. Third is BCA, BCD. And the fourth is CDA. Now what is the sum of the angles? The sum of the angles is 360 degree. The sum of these angles will be 360 degree. Now we are going to study about the adjacent sides and opposite sides of a quadrilateral. So I am drawing one quadrilateral here. Suppose this is a quadrilateral A, B, C, D. What we have to do, we have to write down the adjacent sides and opposite side. Here we are going to write down the, what are the adjacent side of this quadrilateral and what are the opposite sides of this quadrilateral. So first we will go with adjacent side. Suppose this is A. So if I take as A as a reference point, so AB and AD will be the adjacent side. So here what will be the adjacent side? AB and AD. Similarly, if I take B as reference, so BC and BA will be the adjacent side. So it will be BC and BA. If I take C as reference, so CD and C will be the adjacent side. So I can write down there CD and CB. Similarly, if I take DH reference, so it will be DA and DC will be the reference, DA and DC will be the adjacent side. So I will write down DA and DC. Now what do I mean by opposite sides? If I am taking DC, so the opposite of DC will be AB. So I can write down as BC, opposite side will be AB. Similarly, if I take DA, so the opposite side will be CB. Now we are going to study about the properties of quadrilateral. Before starting the properties of quadrilateral, quadrilateral can be typically be of the sizes of like rectangle, squares, parallelogram, rhombus, trapezoid, kite. So we are going to study these all are having four sides. Like the word quad suggests four sides. All these types of quadrilateral will have four sides. So today we are going to study properties of quadrilateral. These are the quadrilateral. The name I have written here. Its properties. The first one is rectangle. It has four angles and opposite sides are equal. This is a rectangle. It has four sides and the opposite side of this angles are equal. It will be of 90 degree. The angle will be of 90 degree and the opposite sides of the rectangle will be equal. This and this will be equal. This and this will be equal. Similarly, this is square, four right angles and four equal sides. Square. This is a square. It will make four right angles. And here four equal sides. Means this side, this side, this side, and this side, they all will be equal. In rectangle, the opposite sides are equal. But in square, all the sides are equal. Now the third one is parallelogram. This is the sign of parallelogram. Don't be confused. Two pairs of parallel sides are parallel and opposite sides are equal. This is a parallelogram. Here two pairs of opposite sides, meaning this and this, this and this will be equal. Now rhombus. Rhombus is it is a parallelogram only, but with four equal sides. Suppose I am making this. Here parallel sides are also equal, and parallelogram with four equal sides. These all sides will be equal. The fourth one is trapezoid. Trapezoid is like this. Here what is said, two sides are parallel, means this side and this side, if I will extend this side and this side will be equal. Now kite, you all know what is kite, it is like in this shape. In kite, the two pairs of adjacent side of the are of same length, means this is the adjacent side, this and this are the adjacent side, there will be equal in length. Now we are going to study quadrilateral formula. These are the quadrilateral. We are going to write down the formula for this quadrilateral. So what is the area of rectangle? That is rectangle. What is the area of rectangle? You all know it is length into breadth. It is length into breadth. Area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. What is area of square? Area of square is side square. You can write down this as side square, or you can write down it as side into side. Okay, this is a square. It will be side square or side into side. You know, all of you know what is area of rectangle. Area of rectangle is length into breadth. Similarly, what we will write down area of parallelogram. That is base into height. Area of parallelogram is base into height. Similarly, what is area of rhombus? We can write down this as base into height or half. We can write down this as base into height. into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. Area of rhombus can be written as base into height, or you can write down this as half into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. Similarly, for area of height also you can write down as base into height, or you can write down half into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. So these are the formula which will required by solving the questions. So these are the quadrilateral formula. For area of rectangle, it is length into breadth. For area of square, it is side square, it is side into side. For area of parallelogram, it is base into height. For area of rhombus and area of height, you can write down as base into height, or you can write down as half into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2.